Ideally speaking, the legacy effect of hypertension I was not knowing before this talk was given to me. So this was totally a new concept for me, and then I started searching what is the legacy effect in the hypertension, because we know the legacy effect in diabetes management, and we treat the diabetes at the earliest and more aggressively. They have reported that macro and microvascular complications which impairs the quality of life, and if you give the good diabetic care, it will prevent and delay these complications. So as such, whenever there is a cardiovascular disease, always we have talked of the comprehensive management, where we have controlled the sugar, blood pressure, lipids, weight, everything. And inter-heart study which was done, which evaluated the determinants of risk of myocardial infarction, had the odds ratio of 1.9 with hypertension. And in inter-stroke study, the hypertension was the leading risk factor with the odds ratio of 3.89. So the risk of stroke was high when blood pressure is high. So these things we are known to us. And the phenomenon of continuous beneficial effect of intensive glycemic control in diabetes is well known. And the complication, even after the cessation of intervention, often returned to metabolic control was observed. UKPDS study investigator, actually they defined the term called legacy. And DCCT and EDIC investigators term as metabolic memory. So these are the various terminologies has been described, either legacy or metabolic memory in terms of diabetes management. But they say that if diseases like hypertension and dyslipidemia, also if you treat aggressively right from the beginning, it reduces the long-term cardiovascular mortality and these effects. But they're not well proven till now. And we know that whenever we want to reduce the cardiovascular risk, we have to manage the LDL cholesterol, antihypertensive therapy, antiplatelets, good glycemic control, lifestyle and weight loss, and all those things is well described. As Dr. Aditya just now spoke, there are various clinical guidelines that are available for the management of hypertension. And NICE guidelines particularly that we used, there is British guidelines, they are basically based on ASCOT and ACCOMPLISH trial. Various other guidelines like JNC, European Society and all, they are based on blood pressure control irrespective of particular drug classes. So whatever trials which has been done in the management of hypertension, they have not done follow-up more than 5 years. So that's why we were not knowing much about the legacy effect of this antihypertensive drug as such. So the concept of legacy, as I told earlier, UKPDS has given the legacy effect, this terminology in glucose reduction. Vascular legacy, there is two, so I would divide this into two types. One is glycemic legacy, that is related to the diabetes management, and another is vascular legacy. So not discussed well adequately till now, and this is a new terminology basically. Many preclinical and clinical studies have suggested the feasibility of such kind of legacy. Clinical data to prove it is lacking till recently. So we do not have much data. The problem was the clinical trials which were done with antihypertensives were not having more than 5 years follow-up. So this actual concept started with the ADVANCE study. And this ADVANCE study, what they did is use of ACE inhibitors and diuretic combination, that is perindopril and endapamide, was used in patient of diabetes irrespective of their blood pressure level. So all the patients of diabetes, they started giving this combination of perindopril and endapamide, or the patient were using any other medications other than ACE inhibitors and diuretics. And what they found is when this combination was given to the patient, major micro and macrovascular events were reduced by 9%, and the risk of death because of cardiovascular disease was reduced by 18%. And these patients of advanced trial, after 4.5 years of follow-up, this trial, when they continued this follow-up, they labeled it as advanced on follow-up trial. So that was like more than 10 years these patients were followed. And they found that further, there was all-cause mortality was reduced by 9%, and then CV mortality was reduced by 12%. So when you follow this patient for a long period of time, more than 4.5 years, there was good response to this patient. And also, there were many meta-analyses was done in almost 18 randomized controlled trial with more than 1.3 lakh patient with follow-up of almost 41 months. And then what they found is subgroup analysis when they did ACE inhibitors and beta blockers, they had odds ratio of 0.8 and reduction of acute myocardial infarction was seen. So earlier you give the medication to the patient for the control of blood pressure, it is results in significant clinical benefits to this patient if you follow them more than 10 years down the line. So that is what they say, that a signal. So this meta-analysis and advanced trial, they gave us a signal that definitely there is some legacy effect or vascular legacy effect exists even for the blood pressure control, as well as there is a glycemic legacy also. So the conclusion of advanced study was the cardiovascular and renal benefits of using perindopril and endapamide administered as a routine therapy, irrespective of the baseline blood pressure, to the all patients of type 2 diabetes. So here the giving perindopril is basically is not for intention of to control blood pressure, but it is basically to prevent the cardiovascular and renal problems to the patient. So it gives primary and secondary prevention in terms of cardiovascular and renal events can be achieved with perindopril and endapamide. And advanced results were had better than the results of MicroHope, because in MicroHope, where the ramipril was used, they had only high-risk subcategory of patient. But in advanced trial, all the patients of diabetes without their risk factors were included, and then they shown that there is very good effects of. So 10 millimeter reduction in systolic blood pressure in patients of type 2 diabetes had reduction of all-cause mortality, macro and microvascular outcomes were seen. And even the small reduction in blood pressure, even in high-risk cardiovascular risk patient, there was good reduction of cardiovascular events in terms of 5 years risk was seen. As just now my colleague Aditya has already pointed out, there are various guidelines are there, and we don't know to what level of blood pressure we should start the medication, but the target should be less than 140 by 90 millimeter of mercury. And the recently, European Society of Congress 2018 guidelines has been published, and they say that for younger patient less than 60, the blood pressure should be less than 130, and for elderly patient, it should be less than 140. So this is the target which has been recently published in ESC guidelines. And then to further clear our concept, to emphasize the vascular legacy effect, came a major trial called ASCOT Legacy Study, where they followed up this patient, those who were enrolled. Basically, it is UK-based study, and they had patient, they studied the long-term effect of mortality in terms of antihypertensive treatment with calcium channel blocker, and lipid-lowering arm was a separate, that was LLA arm, and then BPLA arm, that was a blood pressure-lowering arm, was a separate. And when this, they have given this treatment to the patient with the calcium channel blocker regimen, they had fewer stroke deaths and fewer cardiovascular deaths when there is more than 10-year follow-up. And in ASCOT Legacy Study, what they did is they did follow-up of those patients more than 16 years follow-up, and they found that further you continue the good control of blood pressure, there is further reduction of morbidity and mortality. So this was published in September 2018 in Lancet. The 16-year factorial, 16 follow-up results of randomized factorial trial, and this further continued the our concept that if you give the blood pressure management, better management to this patient, there is reduction of. So this was basically atenolol and amlodipine, where the two antihypertensive drugs were there in this ASCOT, and amlodipine did better in as compared to atenolol. And the study has, in discussion, they have discussed that particularly atenolol did not had good effects because it did not reduce the central aortic pressure, while amlodipine had good reduction of central aortic pressure. So the favoring effects were observed with amlodipine as compared to atenolol. So the rationale of ASCOT Legacy Study, the long-lasting effects of regimen were based on calcium channel blocker, and those were not known. So ASCOT has shown us that there is better effects, long-term effects, benefits in terms of reduction of all-cause mortality and cause-specific mortality. Basically, this was a UK-based trial, and which was a UK cohort study. And this ASCOT Legacy original study, almost 19,000 patients were randomized, and then they were assigned to each 9,000 each patients into amlodipine and atenolol based regime. And what I showed in brief, this patient had good reduction of cardiovascular mortality, peripheral vascular disease, stroke, renal impairment, and new onset diabetes also was reduced. These patients were followed up for almost 5.5 years. And the legacy patient, basically, of which assigned patient, around 8,000 patients, then again 4,000 in each group, atenolol thiazide-based treatment and amlodipine perindopril group, they were followed up. Mean follow-up was 15.7 years. And then what they found is there was a reduction of stroke by almost 29% over the period of 16 years follow-up. And the all-cause mortality was reduced by 9%. Cardiovascular deaths were reduced by 21%. And stroke rates, death rates was less than 33%. So there are definitely the proven benefit of cardiovascular death reduction when perindopril amlodipine combination was given to this patient. And so that's what I told. There is a possible benefit. The load, the central aortic pressure was reduced in this patient better when amlodipine perindopril combination was used as compared to the atenolol treatment. And the possible benefits, like there is a vasodilatation is seen with perindopril and then with amlodipine also. Then there is anti effect and they improve the endothelial function, and amlodipine improves the coronary flow. It reduces the cardiac ischemia. So all these things also can give a good benefit effect to the patient, and there is reduction of mortality, cardiovascular mortality. So to summarize, the ASCOT, this is the first of one of the study which reported the blood pressure lowering effect confirms the long-term cardiovascular benefit. It's one of the trial which followed up patient more than 15 years. And when you use calcium channel blocker therapy, plus or minus, along with the ACE inhibitor like perindopril, it shows the significant reduction of cardiovascular mortality and stroke mortality. And basically, furthermore, findings from the higher baseline group benefits the BP lowering in this kind of patient. And this important implication that benefits of optimal hypertension management are shown, they persist even after the 10 years of the patient. Those who continue the treatment and good control of their blood pressure ensures the long-term reduction of cardiovascular morbidity and mortality. So start early and then continue this therapy, and sooner is the better. So at the earliest, when you see the blood pressure management, hypertension patient, better to start at the early and then continue for the long period of time. Definitely this patient will benefit. So that is what the legacy effect. Thank you.